When you're done with the calculation of the MRP planning in the requisition worksheet as a purchaser in Business Central, you have to run through all the lines and then carry out the lines to create purchase orders. And it's rather easy just to say process, carry out, create purchase orders, and I will do that in a while. But first of all, let me explain the journal lines in here. Action messages new, meaning that it's going to create a new purchase order if I carry out. And when I place the check marks of the action messages, it will bundle all the items for the same vendor on the same purchase order. So in this case, the vendor number is the same, so those will be bundled into one purchase order. Normally you would have many lines also, or you could have lines with change quantity, rescheduling, etc. And you need to take those into account before carrying out. You need maybe to remove some of the check marks. So in this scenario, if I carried out, I would make a purchase order only for the rim, and then afterwards I could make another purchase order for the spokes. So you have to be aware of bundling this and figuring out how to carry out. Normally many purchasers would prefer to plan per vendor just for this purpose, so you won't have too many lines in here, because you have to manually remove and set all this check mark of carrying out action messages. So as you can see here, if we don't check anything and we say carry out, of course nothing will be handled, so the check marks are meant to check mark what you want to handle. And normally if Business Central planning is happy with the suggestion, it will default set the check mark. So now I can just carry out, saying yes. And as you can see, it was thinking, removing the lines. And if I go into my purchase orders, and I'll take the last one. This will be the last purchase order that I just made on the quantities from the journal.